Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Coding Card. So today we'll try to solve one problem from HackerRank. The problem name is Sock Merchant and it's under interview preparation kit and it's a warm-up challenge. So let us go through the problem. The problem states that John works at a clothing store. He has a large pile of socks that he must pair by color for sale. Given an array of integers representing the color of each socks, determine how many pair of socks with matching color are there. For example, there are n equal to 7 socks with color as, this is the color. There is one pair color 1 and one of the color 2. And there are 3 odd socks left, one of each color. So the number of pair is 2. You can see here, one is present 3 times. So, but we can make only one pair from these 3 ones. And there are 3 twos present. So from 3 twos, we can make only one pair. And all our rest are odd numbers, so we cannot make pair. So they have printed 2. So function description is, complete the sock merchant function in the editor below and it must return the integer representing the number of matching pairs. So we have to complete this function sock merchant. And the input format is, the first line contains an integer n, the total number of socks representing in an array. And second line will be the number of colors. This, for example, sample input is, like they have given a sample input 9 and these are the 9 different colors. So you can see here 10 is present 4 times. This is the, suppose they are representing it by a green color. So we can make 2 pair from this. And you can see here blue, like 20 they have represented with blue color. So they have made 1 pair and these are odd numbers. So we cannot make pair from them. So answer they have printed 3. So let us understand here. So the very first thing we have to find is the total count of each pair. Like here we have 10, 4, 4, 10 and 3, 20. Like here in an array we have 10, suppose 20, 10, 20, 10, 20, 10, 50 and suppose 40. Suppose this is the given array. So the very first thing is, we have to find the total count of each color. Suppose here 10 is present how many times? 4 times. 20 is present 3 times. And 50 is present 1 time and 40 is present 1 time. If we have these counts, we can simply have the pair by simply, if you divide 4 by 2, if you divide by 2, we'll get the count for these 2. If I divide 3 by 2, we'll get here 1. 1 divided by 2 won't be getting any value for here. And again 1 divided by 2 will get here 0. So we'll simply print what? We'll simply add these all. After dividing, we'll simply add this value and get our result as 3. So this is a simple logic. We have to first find the total count of each color. We have to find these things. So for this we will simply apply a counter from the collection. So counter, what will do? Counter will keep this value as a key, like 10 as a key and its total count as a value. Again for 20 it will keep as a key and its total count as a value. Again 50 will be kept as a key and its count as a value. And 40 as a key and its count as a value, and it will be a dictionary. And we will simply get this value by, if suppose I have saved this in a C, so we can get this count value by simply getting the value C dot values. So C dot values, it will give the this count values. And if I divide this 2 and add for each, for each value I will add and return the result. So let us write the code. So here we will use a counter. So we will import one, import counter from collection. So from collection import counter. And after that, we'll take one sum variable s equal to 0 initially to add all the sum. Now we'll apply a counter on this array, on the given array. So suppose I'm using counter of array. Okay, it will give me the dictionary of these things, and if I apply dot values, it will give me the value for all. It will give the value, a list of value for all these, like 4, 3, 1, 2. But I will iterate throughout this for val in given thing. This will return me a list. So I will simply apply a counter over there, and I will simply add this value. I'll simply add this value by dividing it with 2. So let me add, I have taken a s equal to 0. So s plus will be val divided by 2. So each time I will get a value, I will divide by 2 and add in the sum. So if it is even number, like here, if it is even number, so it will simply add the quotient, and if it is odd, then simply it will add the quotient. Like 3 here, I will get 1 if I divide with 2. So remainder means odd numbers will be left. Like from 3 we'll get 1. If there is 7, then I will be taking only 3 dividing by 2. Like odds are all ignored. So by dividing here with a single slash will give me a float value. So I will divide with double slash to get an integer value, and I will simply return this value, return s. So this was the asked. We have to return the total count. Let us run this code. So you can see here we are done with the sample input test case. Let us submit this code. So congratulations, we are done with the hidden test cases. So this was a simple problem where we have to just find the total number of counts of each color. So if you like this video, please do give thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next question. Thank you.